Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting this video, we have a tweet from SpaceX about one of their upcoming launches. It says, static fire test of Falcon 9 complete, targeting later this month for first West Coast Starlink mission will announce a target date closer to launch. Inspiration 4 posted a tweet about their mission. They said, Inspiration 4 and SpaceX have completed our flight readiness review and remain on track for launch. Inspiration 4 also posted another tweet with some incredible shots of the cupola installed on the Dragon capsule. They said, a look at Dragon's cupola which will provide our Inspiration 4 astronauts with incredible views of Earth from orbit. The crew visited the flight hardware cupola in California before it was shipped to Florida for integration with Dragon Resilience. There was an interesting article posted by Space Explored about the Inspiration 4 mission. It says SpaceX is flying four private astronauts to orbit on a three-day mission called Inspiration 4, and Apple hardware will be key in a first-of-its-kind research study happening during the flight. These products include Apple Watch Series 6, iPhone 12 Pro, and iPad Mini 4, as selected by SpaceX. Michael Sheets posted a tweet with SpaceX's response to Amazon against SpaceX's Gen 2 Starlinks. It says, SpaceX responds to Amazon's request that the FCC dismiss the Starlink Gen 2 amendment, calling it a continuation of efforts by the Amazon family of companies to hinder competitors and referencing Blue Origin's lawsuit against NASA. Musk gave some Starlink laser interlink information in response to Scott Manley. He said, our satellites launching in next few months have inter-satellite laser links and no local downlink needed, probably active in 4 to 6 months. Then he responded to that tweet with, technically data packets do not need to touch regular internet, data can flow from user terminal to satellites to user terminal. On the Starlink talk, Scott Manley asked another question on Twitter. He asked, is there any real difference beyond the lasers? Do they need more onboard processing for packet routing or were they built with sufficient capacity prior to addition of laser interlinks? Musk responded with, processing is not an issue. Laser links alleviate ground station constraints so data can go from say Sydney to London through space, which is approximately 40% faster speed of light than fiber and shorter path. Also, no need for ground stations everywhere. Arctic will have great bandwidth. Over in Boca Chica, all sorts of work is continuing on the launch tower. Work also continues on the orbital launch mount. Somebody posted some shots on Twitter of some new crane tracks spotted being transported in Germany with a SpaceX logo. Musk responded and said, our new crane. Here's a view of the cryotank shells. The cryotank shell number 6 was rolled out to the launch site during the week. This new structure, possibly a Raptor installation stand, was spotted being worked on. This other new structure is also being worked on. The new wider high bay construction is also continuing at the production yard. On the point of the new high bay, RGV Aerial Photography posted a great shot showing the progress from above. Somebody posted a cool render of two fully stacked starships on orbital pads with the caption 2023. Then Musk responded and instead said 2022. Michael Sheets posted a tweet on Starship saying, SpaceX is hiring a life support systems engineer for Crew Starship which will be used for NASA's HLS program. There is some more information from Michael Sheets related to HLS, but this is instead related to the protest. The tweet says, the DOJ asks the court for an extra business day to file the extremely voluminous record in the HLS lawsuit Blue Origin vs. NASA and SpaceX, which includes over 1700 documents and 16 gigabytes of data to be delivered to the parties on DVDs. The ground support equipment tank GSE-7 is in its final place. The upper section for the GSE-8 tank was sleeved recently. Here's a view of the other pieces of GSE-8 being stacked in the midbay. Starship 20 has a lot less markers on the heat shield tiles as crews work to repair them. Somebody called Artsius posted a picture on Twitter of three Raptor engines. He said Raptors 73, 78 and 69 have arrived on site at the launch pad. As it stands, the only vehicle prepared to receive engines is Ship 20. Super Heavy Booster 4 is still hanging out in the high bay. This common dome was recently sleeved with a barrel section potentially for the Super Heavy Booster 5 prototype. This aft dome, also possibly for Booster 5, was spotted outside in the yard. To finish up this Sunday video, as usual, we have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, I have to say thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Girl for filming the Boca Chica content. Also, once again, I have to thank Nick Ansuini too, who has also been out filming the Boca Chica content recently. Then, as always, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.